In summary, the PowerZ tool is a useful USB device for performing consumption analysis of devices. The included software is intuitive and easy to use, allowing for accurate calibration and energy savings through the energy-saving future. This tool is ideal for those who want to perform consumption analysis of devices in a quick and easy way. Measurement of the SMD components is the fifth step. We have to know how to measure the capacitance of the capacitors in microfarads, nanofarads, or picofarads, measure the bobbin in henries, measure the resistor in ohms, and so on. Here I leave you a selection of the SMD components, which practically represents 98% of all the components of the motherboard. These components are capacitor, resistors, bobbins, diodes, filters, thermistors, varistors, integrated circuits, voltage reducers, SMD leads, crystal oscillator, and voltage regulator. Just take a paper and write down a short description of each one, because we won't take long. SMD capacitors. They are used to temporarily store and release electricity. SMD resistors. They are used to regulate or limit the amount of current flowing through a circuit. SMD bobbins. They are used to store current and generate an electromagnetic field. SMD diodes, they are used to regulate the direction in which current flows. They practically allow current to pass in one direction and block it in the opposite direction. There are several types. SMD filters, they are used to block certain unwanted frequency, is an element that discriminates a certain frequency or range of frequencies from an electronic signal passing through it, being able to modify both its amplitude and its phase. SMD thermistors, they are used to detect changes in temperature. The thermistor is based on the variation of the resistance of the semiconductor due to the change in the ambient temperature. SMD varistors, they are used to limit the flow of current and protect circuits from voltage variations. Integrated circuits, they are used to perform a variety of signal processing tasks such as arithmetic and logic operation. The function of the integrated circuit is to simplify an electronic function. The name tells us circuit integrate all the electronic circuit within one. There are electronic devices composed of one or more transistor, diodes, resistor, and other components connected together to perform a specific function. These circuits are used to amplify, process, store, and control signals. For example, the PMIC, the Wi-Fi IC, and the audio IC. Voltage reducers, used to reduce voltage to save lever or buck converter, which can have a high efficiency, over 95% with integrated circuits, and self-regulation. SMD LEDs, used as visual indicators to show the status of a circuit. Oscillator crystal used to generate clock signals at a constant rate, practically to create an electrical signal with a precise frequency. Voltage regulator used to stabilize the voltage in a circuit, solve the voltage drop problem, and keep the line voltage within predetermined limits. FPC connectors. They are plastic connectors that allow data transfer between a peripheral and a motherboard. For example, to connect the camera, the display, the charging connector, and the sub-motherboard. Learning to diagnose failure in a mobile phones requires knowing the SMD components and how to measure each one. These 13 components are the most important on a motherboard. Among the 13 components, we have these four: capacitors, bobbins, resistors, and integrated circuits that represent 19% of all the components of the motherboard. To diagnose a failure, it's important to know the operation of each component and how to measure it correctly. In this way, it will be possible to know if the component is damaged or badly installed. This will allow not only to repair the device, but also to prevent future problems in the case of water damages devices. In this course, we are not going to waste time to teach you how to measure each component. We have in our YouTube channel measurements of all of these components. Throughout the course, we'll be measuring a wide variety of components, and in this way, we'll learn it as well. These were the five measurement protocols that all technicians need to know. And we left for the end the oscilloscope that can help us to measure a variety of signals, including noise, frequencies, signal voltages, rise and fall times, and waveforms. These tools are used to help professionals to understand better the information that they received from the electronic motherboards. The oscilloscope offers a unique view of a signal patterns, allowing users to see and understand how to analyze signals behave. With an oscilloscope, you can perform various tasks, such as directly determining the period and voltage of a signal, indirectly determining the frequency of a signal, determining which part of the signal is continuous and which is alternative, locating failure in a circuit, measuring the phase between two signals, and determining what part of the signal is noise and how it varies over time. These tasks can be carried out to make a diagnosis of a failure. The measurement protocols are fundamental for technicians to ensure the precision of the repairs and improve the working times. These steps allow to minimize the repair time, to increase productivity, to improve safety and reliability of the repairs. The five most important measurement protocols are continuity test, voltage measurement, diode measurement, SMD component measurement, and current measurement. In conclusion, to use an oscilloscope can allow users to better understand the information they received from the electronic systems.